Welcome to Lennox Actuator Academy video series for industrial actuators. I'm Hunter, and today we're going to talk a little bit about DC motors, their functionality, and how to achieve optimal motor efficiency in a linear actuator. An electric linear actuator is made up of three main components: the gears, the spindle, and the motor. These are typically connected like this. A DC motor is a rotary machine that converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. Let's take a look at the components inside of a DC motor. Inside the stator, or the motor's housing, permanent magnets are mounted, and they create a constant magnetic field inside of the DC motor. An axle goes all the way through the DC motor, and around the axle is an armature, which is an electromagnetic coil connected to DC power via commutator rings. All of these components rotate inside of the DC motor. Two brushes inside of the DC motor transfer DC power to the electromagnetic coil inside of the DC motor. The ball bearings on the outside of the DC motor ensure minimal friction between the axle and the outer elements of the motor itself. The functionality of a DC motor is based on the principle of induction. Induction is the electromagnetic field that is induced when applying current through a coil. When the coil finally rotates to the opposite magnetic field, the brushes will make contact with the opposite commutator rings that create the opposite polarity. This means that the electromagnetic pull will switch direction and the coil will continue rotating in the same direction. The efficiency of a DC motor is the relationship between power input and power output, measured in watts. The higher the load, the higher the power consumption of the actuator will be. Examples of efficiency losses inside of the DC motor start with mechanical losses such as the bearing friction and the commutator friction, core losses from the coil design and magnetic losses from the magnet design. We have copper losses from the winding factor, also called the fill factor, as well as losses from the copper's resistance. And we have stray losses such as magnetic flux losses. All of these inefficiencies result in the generation of heat and noise, which can never be avoided. Duty cycle is related to this because heat buildup inside of the actuator's housing is what determines that duty cycle. Now let's take a look at some of the prerequisites for achieving a high actuator efficiency, which is closely linked to the motor's efficiency. The first requirement is to have stable motor performance from a stable power supply, providing the nominal voltage to the DC motor. External conditions, such as cabling, also have an effect on the DC motor's efficiency. This short cable right here, for example, is going to have a lot lower resistance than this super long cable here. A good rule of thumb for this is the shorter the cable and the thicker the cable, the less resistance it has to the flow of current to the DC motor. This resistance generates heat and, as previously mentioned, is evidence of energy loss. Another requisite of having the highest efficiency DC motor is choosing the right input voltage. In case you choose to run a DC motor with over or under voltage, you can overload the motor. For example, by over voltage, the motor will rotate faster and provide a higher output, but it will have a higher power dissipation and generate a higher temperature. If the duty cycle is not reduced or the heat's not removed from the motor's copper windings, the motor can be damaged. When too little voltage is applied, we have the opposite situation with less power dissipation but reduced motor performance. This creates a risk of stalling where the motor stops rotating, as well as increased current consumption that can overheat and damage the motor. These factors also have an influence on the motor efficiency. Ball bearings that reduce rotational friction between the axle shaft and housing, load capacity of the magnets, the space of air between the rotor and the magnet, the smaller the gap, the better the efficiency, smoothness of the brushes and commutators in the motor, the resistance of the copper coil inside the motor and in the outside cabling. And finally, surrounding temperatures also have an effect on the motor efficiency. For example, the friction of the mechanical parts inside the motor is larger at cold temperatures because grease has a higher viscosity. But when the motor gets cooler, the heat in the motor is reduced and it becomes more efficient. So this was a bit about how DC motors work and how to get an optimal actuator efficiency, which is related to the actuator's DC motor. If you have any questions about DC motors for electric linear actuators, feel free to contact your local LINAC office. Thank you so much for watching.